Hi guys, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Smitha. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you a neutral soft cut crease on hooded eyes with smudged kohl liner and just a tad bit of glitter, just perfect for any occasion. So if you're ready, let's begin. The first step is to prime the lids, and for that I'm using my favorite Milani concealer in the shade 145. I'm just applying it with the applicator to clean up underneath my brows, and I'm going to use a flat shader brush to drag it down all the way to my lid and even it out. And then I'm very lightly setting it with the Airspun translucent powder just to dry up the concealer so it absorbs it and does not crease. If you observe my lid, there's a line passing right across my lid. That's my crease line. Now, if I apply makeup up until my crease line and then open my eyes, you won't be able to see the eye makeup because everything is going to hide under the hood. So we'll construct a new crease right above my natural crease line on top of the hood. From the Wet n Wild Coffin Break palette, I'm using the black eyeshadow. Looking straight in the mirror, I'm going to mark a point over my hood where I want to cut the crease. So when I open my eyes, I should be able to see that point. And then I'm going to connect it to the inner corner as well as extend it to the outer end. Now this is going to be my new crease above my natural crease line. To soften this, I'm using a brown eyeshadow with a blending brush. I'm going to go over the black eyeshadow, softening it. And then using my favorite Milani brush, I'm going to start dabbing over this so I can soften it further. And then using the Milani concealer, I'm going to start cleaning up under the lid. I'm just using very little concealer just to make my cut crease sharp. I'm not going to be painting my entire lid space because it's pretty clean and there wasn't much fallout. It's time for kohl or kajal, and for that I'm going to be using a black eye pencil from Wet n Wild. You can also use a gel liner or any black eye pencil that you have. I'm going to first tight line and then I'm going to use it in my lash line. If you're planning to use gel liner, one of my favorites from the drugstore is the Maybelline gel liner. It goes on really smooth and it's very pigmented. Using my finger, I'm going to sharpen the wing in the outer corner. That's the easiest way to do it when you use pencils. And then using some black eyeshadow, I'm going to start smudging it. And because we're smudging it, when you apply the eye pencil, it doesn't have to be perfect because you'll be smudging it anyway. Using the eye pencil, I'm going to also extend my inner corner, and then using a flat definer brush, I'm going to extend it further so it looks sharper. And then using the Milani concealer, I'm going to sharpen the wing in the outer corner by cleaning up underneath. From the Etude House Rosé Wine Palette, I'm going to be using this very fine glitter. It's actually an eyeshadow but has very fine glitter. I'm going to be using it in the very outer corner above my kohl liner. It's time to finish up with some mascara, but before that I'm curling my lashes. And for mascara, I'm using the Big Popper mascara. This is a new one from Wet n Wild. And for lashes, I'm using my favorite Black Label lashes in Brazen. What I personally love about these lashes is they're glamorous, but they're still wispy in the center, so you can still see through and see the lid space, and it wings out, so it elongates your eyes as well. And here is the completed eye look. As you can see, the lid space looks so much more bigger. And what I love about this kind of an eye look is it's neutral, so it's very wearable, but at the same time looks so glamorous. I'm going to pair this with a beautiful baby pink lip liner from Jordana in Rose Crush. And then I'm going to top it off with a lip gloss from Milani in Teen Spirit. If you didn't know, Jordana as the business closed last December. So you can use any baby pink or any nude lipstick with this look and it'll look absolutely stunning. And if you want to go bold, you can also use a red lipstick. And here's the completed look. If you recreate this look, please don't forget to tag me, especially in stories on Instagram if you want me to share it. All the links are listed down below in the description box. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several videos a week. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.